Since Shiloh came to live with us, I've thought a lot about right and wrong, even good and bad, and I'm always so surprised at how close opposites tend to be. That's Judd Travers. He used to own Shiloh. Shiloh ran away after Judd beat him real bad. I found Shiloh and decided no matter what, I was gonna get him away from Judd. Even if that meant lying to my whole family. No doubt about it. There were some hard choices to make. But after a lot of heartache, some good advice from Doc Wallace, and some mean words between me and Judd, we struck a deal. I'd work for him, and then Shiloh would be mine. Even though Judd almost didn't keep his side of the bargain, in the end, he did. But one moment in someone's days can't wipe a whole life of meanness away. And Judd was still mad. He still wanted his dog back. And now, he was drinking worse than ever. Judd almost ran me over.
He what?
Me and Shiloh were on our way home, and we heard this noise, like an engine revving up.
You think he did it on purpose?
I don't know. After he passed us, he was still driving crazy.
Well, Ray, this is serious.
Well, I'm hearing right. He's drinking again. He's topping off at a bar at Ben's Run.
Well, Marty, you best keep off the road. And you too, Darylin.
Why'd he start drinking so hard all of a sudden?
Maybe he's thirsty.
I think Judd drinks because he's unhappy.
Maybe he misses Shiloh.
No, why? He's got all those other dogs to keep him company.
The fact that his dog kept running away and coming to you, Marty, and the way you kept working for him, even when he called you a fool, I think that made him take a good hard look in the mirror, and it wasn't pretty.
Judd's not pretty.
Oh, you got that right. Well, the real problem is, he's hunting our land. Yeah, I heard two shots yesterday, same as last weekend, and then I go up there, and I found this beer can, same kind as Judd drinks.
But, Ray, we've got those woods posted.
I know that.
Well, you've got to talk to him. I don't want him up there drunk, firing off his gun this way and that. I mean, one of those bullets is going to end up down here.
Scared he's going to come after Shiloh. Try and take him back.
Calm down, okay? Calm down. I'm going to talk to him tonight after dinner, okay? So let's enjoy ourselves. Evening, Judd.
Late be working, ain't it?
Well, I'm not working, Judd. I'm here on personal business. I found this up in my woods.
Yeah?
I know you've been hunting my land. Hadn't we talked about this before? I posted those woods and fields, and there's no hunting.
Well, you don't think I'm going to pay attention to some stupid signs you put up, do you?
Can't go hunting your neighbor's land when they tell you not to.
Well, you're a sorry excuse for a neighbor, Ray Preston. Keeping your land for yourself to hunt on.
I don't hunt my own land. I have children down at the house. It's dangerous.
If I'd known what a miserly skunk you are, I never would have given your kid the best hunting dog I ever had.
Your deal with Marty for Shiloh had nothing to do with hunting on my land.
Oh, it sure did. He said I could hunt your land any time I wanted to. That was part of the bargain.
You know what you just said? That was a bald-faced lie.
Tell your kid I want my dog back.
If you set foot on my property or threaten my family in any way, including Shiloh, I'll call the sheriff on you.
What do you think Judd's saying?
No telling. He's liable to deny it or get mad, maybe. But he has got to stop hunting here. Drinking will make a person do things he never thought he'd do. You put a drink in someone like Judd, you got a bomb just waiting to go off. Well, what'd he say?
I think it might be a good idea if the kids didn't play up in the woods for a while. And we all ought to keep a close eye on Shiloh.
Big ol' hunting dog to Marty Preston for 20 hours work. Signed, Judd Travers. We had a deal, Shiloh. Why can't he just let it go? All right, come on in, find your seats. Settle down. Welcome to seventh grade. My name is Miss Talbot. I'm from Philadelphia, and I moved to Friendly about 4 months ago. And I'm really excited to be your teacher for this year. I thought we'd jump right in and get started on an assignment. It's a little project that'll help tell me a little bit about who you are, and you might be amazed to find out a little something about yourselves. Imagine the future. I'd like you to think about what jobs you'd most like to have when you grow up and write a little report on it, okay?
Could you believe what Michael said about all the broken mailboxes?
I know, it has to be Judd.
Probably, but it could be some kids from Sistersville High.
Get real.
Judd's just a dangerous drunk. He should be in jail.
Stay over at David's on Friday, and could you stay on Saturday?
Sure.
Thanks.
Hi, Mom.
Hey, how are you?
Good.
There's a snack for you in the kitchen.
Okay.
You can go in too.
You want?
I want to show you something. Look at that. Just look at that. Just look at that, Marty. You got any idea who might have scratched up my truck?
No.
You don't know any boys who might have done it?
Nobody I know.
Well, you keep your ears open. If you hear anybody might have done it, you let me know.
I'll listen around.
Okay. We gonna find out who scratched up my truck, ain't we? And I'm gonna keep my eye open, and you keep your eye open, too. If you hear anything, you let me know. All right?
Okay.
Okay. We'll see you. Hey, boy. Goop, goop, goop.
Listen, Shiloh, I'm not going to be back tonight, but I'll be back tomorrow, okay? Bye.
When did Ms. Talbot say our reports are due? I think next Friday.
Marty.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, honey. Why don't you boys wash up? We'll eat dinner in about an hour, okay?
Okay.
Good to see you.
Good to see you, too.
Let's go to my room.
Pumpkin pie.
Your favorite.
And David's favorite, too, if I remember right. So how's your dog, Marty?
Oh, he's doing really good. Except he don't like to see me climb on the bus each morning.
Doesn't. He doesn't like to see you climb on the bus.
No, I sure don't.
You know, I've heard some talk that Judd still thinks the dog is his. He's just been lending him to you.
No, sir. Shallow's mine, and Judd knows it.
I thought as much.
I think the less discussion about Judd, the better.
I think you're right.
David. Hey, David. You wake me.
Okay, boys, let's pack it in. Time for some shut-eye.
Show me that mask.
It's my Judd Travers werewolf mask.
That don't look like Judd.
Sure it does. Judd's a werewolf.
You're nuts.
A vampire?
David.
You know what? There's no way we're ever going to find out if we don't go spy on him tomorrow.
What if Judd catches us?
He'll never find out. Come on.
Maybe. Hey, Charlotte. To wonder. Hello.
Hello there, beautiful.
Marty, here's the sandwich, honey. You gotta get to Doc's.
Thanks, Mom.
And where's my hug? Mrs. Howard, have a good dinner?
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah? How good?
Not like your mama's dinners.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
You know just what to say.
Doc, I'm ready to work.
Okay. I tell you what I want you to do. You take this pot and put it over there because I want it to have more sun. And I want to get this all finished before my wife comes home, okay? Because she thinks I can't do anything and I want to surprise her.
All right, no problem.
Okay, thank you.
You pull out the old weeds and I'll start watering the flowers.
Okay.
Here.
Thanks.
Come here. Come over here. Over here. Come on. Oh, you are a sweetheart.
Shiloh!
Let me take a look at that. Boy, you did a great job. Keep this up, pretty soon you won't owe me anything.
Thanks, Doc. I'll work for you anytime. You saved my dog's life.
Do you want to stay for dinner tonight, Marty?
No, I can't. David's spending the night tonight.
Maybe another time.
Oh, wait a minute. What about dinner tomorrow?
Sure.
Good.
Listen, Doc, I've been meaning to ask you. Do you think a person can ever change? I mean, once they're mean, are they mean forever?
I don't know. I heard that, you know, a little kindness can change man and beast.
Even Judd?
I don't know. I hope so.
You're finished!
finished. What a beautiful garden.
Yeah, we worked ourselves to death. We broke our backs, didn't we, gang?
Yep.
Ah.
I think we're going to go outside for a while, Mom.
Okay.
Don't go too far, though.
Hey, Mom. You ready to head out yet?
I don't know. I saw Jed this morning. He was acting pretty weird. If he catches his spine...
Look, we're passing other houses on the way there. Just think of it as a walk through the neighborhood.
But we're spying. You know, Jed warned me about spying, and I promised him I wouldn't.
Look, he's probably inside by now anyway. Or off in a bar somewhere getting drunk. All right. Now, how long will it take to get to Jed Travers?
About 10 minutes.
All right, we're gonna need a map, a canteen, a pair of binoculars.
A map?
David, come on. All we're doing is walking across the bridge and then walking along the road till we get to Judd's.
We gotta go a different way. I mean, how do you expect to spy on somebody if they see you walking right up the road?
I'll get some paper and a pen.
Here.
What about the canteen and binoculars?
Already got them. You know, when I was back in Europe, we used to play spy all the time. Man, this is gonna be a blast.
It's okay, Shiloh. You can go on home, boy.
Why wouldn't Shiloh come across?
I don't know.
Never has.
Guess he remembers where he's from.
Laughing, I'll sing, and my heart will be gay.
You going hunting?
I don't think so.
He promised to us. Well, he taught me to love him. He promised to love him.
No, don't! Get down!
Who said that? Who said that? That sounded like a Marty Preston to me. Is that you, Marty? What you doing on my land? Your pa won't let me hunt yours. What you doing on mine?
Pressings are all alike. Stinky little coward.
Marty Preston! I catch you fooling around with my truck. I'm gonna blow you to kingdom come.
Thank you.
squirrel could have been us. I know it was close to spit. The squirrel didn't even do anything.
He knew it was you, Marty.
I know he does.
He doesn't even play by the stupid hunting rules.
I know. Squirrel's out of season. Duck season starts in October and deer season starts in November.
Well, he obviously doesn't care about the stupid hunting seasons, Marty.
Nothing on the charts about dog season. Well, he's acting, he's making his own laws. What if he makes it shiloh season?
Think we should tell him?
About the squirrel? You could, but it wouldn't do one bit of good.
I mean, you ever heard of someone getting fined for shooting a squirrel out of season? You can walk from here to Sister's Room and find half a dozen dead on the road. It's not just that he killed it. It's about how much fun he had when he did it. I mean, what do you suppose his parents were like raising a guy like him?
What do you suppose he was like?
Maybe it's just Judd. Nothing his parents could do about it, you know? Just a plain bad apple. One thing's for sure, he's never ever gonna change.
I don't know.
Well, you two must have been up all night.
No, we're okay.
Want to eat your pancakes?
Your dad just pulled up.
Yes.
Bye, Marty. Bye, Miss Preston.
Bye, David.
Bye, David.
Thanks for breakfast.
I'm going for a little walk. No, Shiloh, you gotta stay here, okay, boy? I'm going to Doc's later. I don't want to tire him out.
Okay. Just you and me, Shiloh. Now I've got to get a new spoon.
The only reason I didn't report Judd's hunting out of season or poaching. It's because I wanted to save Shiloh. Now I suppose he'll go right on doing that. Dad says he's even been hunting up in our woods. Probably even drunk. Sometimes I can't sleep good. Worrying about if all this is right.
Some people think there's an answer to everything. You can be right about everything. That's not true. It doesn't work that way.
Even for you?
Yeah, even for me. I remember when I was a kid, you know, I tell a lie, my father, he whipped me. After a while, I figured that it's better to tell the truth. Even when I went to school or I went to college, I never, ever cheated on a test.
Not even a little bit?
Not even a little bit. The tests of life, they get harder. They get harder for you as a doctor. They get harder for you as a man.
What do you think I should have done about Judd, then?
I can't tell you that.
Why not?
Because it's your test. Go on.
I'm just fooling around the creek.
Yeah? You taking good care of my dog?
Yeah, Shiloh's doing fine.
How come he ain't with you now?
He's back at home with Ma. Getting spoiled.
Yeah, well, you don't take a dog hunting, he'll lose his touch.
Well, I ain't much of a hunter. Besides, hardly anything's in season.
Got a fact.
Listen, Judd. I came to tell you something.
Yeah?
David and me. He was over at my house yesterday and we were playing spot. That was us here in your yard.
How come you didn't answer me then?
We're scared because you had that gun.
You expect me to believe that? You come all the way over here just to play spy. You weren't playing, boy. You were spying. And it wouldn't surprise me a bit if your pa didn't put you up to it.
He didn't. He didn't even know we were over here. But we shouldn't have been...
You're right, you shouldn't have been in my yard. You two boys been over here once means you've been over here more than that. Any two boys sneaking around my house won't even answer. You got more on your minds than play, boy. Well, I bet it was you and him that scratched up my truck. I catch you over here again, I won't be shooting in the air.
Judd, I...
That man's got a right to protect his property.
But Judd...
Go on home.
Judd?
Go on! Get!
Judd!
Go on home! Get out of here!
Something I didn't tell you. Me and David saw Judd shoot a couple of squirrels.
What? What were you doing over there?
Playing spy.
I bet that was David's idea. Why do you listen to everything he tells you to do?
I don't.
Well, he's gonna get you in trouble.
I heard him. I went and told Judd that it was me spying. Boy, was he angry.
Sweet little Shiloh. All this over you.
I know. It's crazy, but Shiloh's like a part of my family. It's like he comes into my life one day, and I do anything to make sure he doesn't get hurt. I know he's just a dog. It doesn't make any sense.
Sure it does. He's your friend. He'd do the same thing for you.
I saw my moment today. He's really lost a step.
I remember when Grandma Preston was so smart and funny.
And that's how we should remember her. That's the way she really is.
It's the same with Grandma Slater. She was sharp her whole life. If she hadn't gone out in the rain, picking beans, got pneumonia, she'd probably be alive yet.
If she was so sharp, how come she was picking beans in the rain?
Well, we all do things now and again we shouldn't.
Oh, well, that's the truth.
What's that?
Oh, my Lord. It's Judd Travers. Girls, go upstairs. It's important.
I think it is. I come home today and find my mailbox flat over on the ground. Not a scratch on it. So I know no car backed into it by accident.
I'm sorry to hear that, boy.
I think your boy was over there today and knocked over my box. Him, that Howard kid. Or that girl at Doc's, maybe.
But, Judd, I did...
Marty. Now, why do you think Marty did it?
Because somebody scratched up my truck a week or two back. I'm thinking it's Marty what done it. I want him over at my place tomorrow digging me a new hole. And I want that post set in cement.
But I didn't do it, Dad. I didn't scratch up his truck, neither.
You sure of that?
Yeah, I'm sure.
You know who might have done it?
No.
And you gonna believe a kid who'd go over to my place, hiding on my property? Sneaking around spying on me, and then telling you he don't know nothing about my mailbox. Well, what's he doing on my property then? Him and that Howard kid. You ask him that.
Now, look, I'm gonna talk to my boy one-on-one. And that's where we do things here. Now, it might just be that you've been knocking down a fixer boxes your own lately, where you've been driving. Somebody's trying to settle the score, and I'm just guessing.
Well, I'm guessing it was your kid. And until he puts up my box, you're in for a lot of trouble.
Oh, now, don't start saying things like that.
Don't be telling me what to say, Ray. When you can't even control your own boy, keep him from destroying people's property.
That man is just crazy.
Louise, Marty and I are going to have a talk.
Okay.
Marty, is that true what Judd said about you spying on him?
We were just playing spy.
What did you do?
We were crawling around like spies. We wanted to see what Judd does.
What do you think he does?
I don't know. He was sitting on his steps with a shotgun. And we saw him shoot a squirrel. He was about to shoot another one, but I yelled, "No, don't!" I couldn't help myself. Then David pushed my head down. We stayed hid that way.
You know, if you tried, you could not have picked the worst time to do something like this. Now, what about the mailbox and Scratch's truck? Are you involved with that?
No, I already told you.
How do I know you're telling the truth? You lied once before, remember?
I know, but I'm not lying now. Dad, I promise you, I'm not lying.
All right, listen up. We got a man here who's drinking heavy, okay? And he doesn't even remember what he does when he's drunk, and he's getting ready for hunting season. He's dangerous. So, I don't want you crossing that bridge. I want you as far away from Judd Travis as you can get.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Dad?
Yeah?
I didn't mess around with his truck or his mailbox. If there's some way for you to believe that, just tell me.
Just stay out of trouble. That's all I ask.
Okay. I had never seen Dad so troubled before. But it'll be okay. You gotta stay in the house till we get this whole thing settled. Okay?
See you tomorrow. Marty.
Yeah.
Everything okay with you?
Yeah, sure. Why?
It just seemed like you have a lot on your mind.
I know, but I'm okay.
How's your presentation coming?
Okay, I guess. It's hard even though I already know what kind of job I want to have.
Yeah. Just remember, when you're thinking about what you want to do with your life, have it come from here. Not just here.
Okay, thanks.
Sure. I'll see you tomorrow.
No, Shiloh, don't go over there, boy! You know you're not supposed to go up there.
Let's play hide and seek.
All right, just for a minute, though.
Shiloh can play, too.
Okay, I'll be it. You two go hide.
Becky, hide. 1003, 1004. Don't go up there, Becky.
1,001, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004, 1,005, 1,006, 1,007, 1,009, 1,050.
Ready or not, here I come. Becky, darling, where are you?
That was a good idea. Just about. Okay, it's time to go in now. Let's find Becky and Shiloh.
Okay. Becky, Shiloh, come on out.
Becky, it's okay to come out now.
Becky?
Becky!
I already got Darlene. Come on, Becky.
Becky, come out.
Shiloh?
Becky, where are you?
Becky! Becky, Shiloh,
Becky,
come
Shiloh.
Out. Becky! Becky, where are you? Becky! Becky, Shiloh!
Where is she, little Shiloh?
What's going on?
We can't find Becky. We're playing hide and seek and we can't find her.
What? Well, where did you last see her?
By the car. She called for Shiloh to go with her. She was heading up to the woods before, but I told her not to.
If Becky wandered off, why didn't Shiloh go with her? Why isn't he with her?
Mom?
Darlene, go in the house in case she shows up, all right?
Becky?
Becky!
Where are you? Ray?
Honey, don't go up there. Let me search the woods. You go down by the creek. Oh, and Marty?
Becky!
I want you to sit on the porch, keep an eye on the yard. I don't want her to think that
Becky!
We're all gone and then go off again, understand?
Where are you?
Yes, sir.
Becky!
Shiloh, why couldn't you have just stayed with her? Why couldn't you have just done that one thing? Go somewhere else, boy.
Honey, I gotta call the sheriff and ask for some help.
Ray?
Yeah?
You don't think he'd just come up here and take her, do you?
Oh, Angel, no. Jed Travis wouldn't do anything like that even if he was drunk. I'm worried.
This is getting out of hand.
Go outside, boy.
I'm worried he might be in the woods shooting his gun off. Hello, Sheriff. Ray Preston. Hey, we got a problem here.
What is it, Shiloh? What is it, boy?
We found her!
Oh, hold it. I think we found her. I'll call you back. You know how terrified we were.
Shiloh was looking out for her the whole time. Let me write to her.
I was so scared, Marty.
Me too.
It sure would have saved a lot of worry if Shiloh could talk.
He did talk. We just didn't ask the right questions. He knew where she was the whole time.
She must have gone in there to hide and just fell asleep.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's when we all went in the house without her.
Shiloh figured he ought to let us know.
Thank you, ladies. Okay, back to the game. Sam, you still want to be a dancer?
No, I think a swimmer. Isn't that right, Happy?
A swimmer? What kind of job is that?
Swimming champion.
That's more like it. What are you going to do?
I either want to be a biologist, a forest ranger, and if I can't do that, then I'll probably be a rocket scientist.
Outside of that, you got no ambitions, right?
Marty!
Well, I'd probably put down a veterinarian technician, because I know my parents couldn't afford to send me to vet school.
Well, you know, I know it's difficult, cost money to get in school and everything, but listen to me. If you have a dream and you work hard enough, it'll happen. Okay, now I gotta go back in and what?
Mind the store.
There we go.
Hi, we're here with Shiloh. Preston.
Oh, good. Dr. Collins will be right with you.
Wonderful, thanks.
Mom? Shiloh have to get more shots. He just got his rabies shots.
Well, dogs are susceptible to all sorts of things. That's why.
Marty, did you know puppies have worms in them?
Yeah, I've heard that before. Dogs can get them too.
Live ones? Crawling around inside of them? Maybe Shiloh's got him.
Suppose he could have him.
Well, how would they know?
You have to look in his poop.
Ew, yuck.
But it's true.
I know.
Hey, so this is Shiloh. Doc Wallace told me all about him. Come on back. Okay, there we go. Okay, well, Marty, you've taken real good care of him. And this old wound looks all healed.
Listen, Dr. Collins, I have a couple questions for you for a paper for school.
Sure, what's that?
Chaining dogs makes them mean, doesn't it?
Well, it makes them scared, so they act mean. And they feel trapped. And if another dog or a person comes along and they feel they might be attacked, they'll act fierce to scare them off.
And these dogs stay mean for life?
No, no, they don't have to. I mean, once you unleash a dog and they don't feel so threatened and know that they can get away if they need to. I mean, they may not settle down right away, but once they know they can trust you and you'll treat them right, they can become a loyal, kind dog.
Wow, so they really can change. I didn't think that was possible. Thanks, Dr. Collins.
Sure.
Don't get any ideas about Judd's dogs, Marty.
How's it coming?
Good.
Becky, turn that down.
Okay.
You hear that? Is that barking?
Yeah, it sounds like that lab that sometimes comes around.
Oh, no, that's more than one dog, Marty. Becky, where's Darylin?
Outside picking apples.
Stay inside, Becky. Darylin! Get in the house right now! Get away!
fool said. All right.
Marty, whose dogs are those?
Judd's. They got loose and one of them bit Daryl Lynn.
Doc, it's Louise Preston. Daryl Lynn just got bit by one of Judd's dogs. Yes, they're running loose, headed over the bridge, I think. No, it's not too deep, but it did puncture the skin. Oh. Okay. Yes. Thank you very much.
Marty, are you sure they were Judd's dogs?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Doc's gonna call the sheriff and get those dogs picked up right away. He said that the one that bit Daryl Lynn has got to be locked up for 10 days to see if he's got rabies. And if he does, she's got to get shots.
No.
We can't even have our kids play in our front yard, Ray. It's just craziness.
Mommy.
Now, Becky, you're not the one that got bit, so quit your crying. All right, let's just all go out and sit in the porch and take a breather here. I have got to have 5 minutes of peace and quiet or my head is going to fly straight off. I know it hurts, but you can put a little pressure on it.
Marty, how in the world those dogs get loose? Judd has chains on him, but I held a grown man. Were they dragging their chains or what? I didn't notice.
No, they're unhooked by the collar.
Oh, I don't understand. Well, look who's coming.
Ray Preston, I accuse you of turning my dogs loose.
I did no such thing, so go home and calm down.
Then you put your boy up to it.
Marty didn't have anything to do with it.
Well, somebody come by and unchained all three of them. And Miss Young says she saw my dogs coming off of your property.
They were here, all right. And the yellow one bit my daughter. Daryl Lynn, show him. If Marty hadn't picked Daryl Lynn up, there is no telling what they might have done to her.
That is a put-up lie I ever heard one. Sheriff tells me he finds my dogs. He's gonna lock that one up in a cage for 2 weeks.
They have to wait that long to be tested. Any dog that bites someone has to be watched.
I see what you're up to. And don't think I don't. You got my best dog, and now you're cooking up some story about my second dog. It's going to cost me 2 good weeks of hunting. I could sure use that beagle.
No.
Judd, why don't you sit down, and we can talk this over man to man without getting all hot under the collar.
I ain't sitting down. I ain't got nothing to say, except you owe me the use of that dog.
You can't have him.
Becky, be quiet.
Even if we were to let Shiloh go, he wouldn't come.
Oh, you come all right. Where is he?
See, he wouldn't even come out.
Darling.
Come on out. Come on out, dog. All right. You gonna be like that? We can do something about it.
No! You're not going after my dog with that broom!
Judd, put that broom down. That dog belongs to Marty, and you don't have permission to take him. Now, I know you're all upset about your dog getting loose and all, but acting this way is not gonna help.
We've got a daughter with a bite on her leg, Judd, but we're not going to press charges, so there's no cause for any of us to be mad at each other.
Judd, I said put that broom down.
I ain't through with you, Ray Preston. You and that boy are behind this. I'd bet anything on it.
You ain't seen the last of me. You ain't heard the last of me. And I'm telling you now, you're gonna be sorry.
The dog that bit you. Yeah, he said it must have been Judd that knocked down our mailbox twice.
What about Mrs. McAllister's cat? She was just sitting on the steps and those dogs just killed it.
Fred Niles' dad said it was the guy that Judd got in a bar fight with. Said he just let all the dogs out while Judd was at work.
I think it's terrible. Judd should go to jail. I mean, if those dogs snatched up a cat, they could snatch a baby.
I was talking to Dr. Collins, and he said that even mean pack dogs can turn to nice dogs. Just take some time and kindness.
Yeah, like they're gonna get that from Judd.
I understand you're all concerned about what happened with Daryl and Preston and Mrs. McAllister's cat. And while we know that Judd's dogs got loose and caused these things to happen, we don't know how they got loose. We don't know the truth about a lot of stories we've heard about Judd's behavior. Now, truth is what you see with your own eyes and hear with your own ears. Gossip may or may not be true. Because you're hearing it from another person, and maybe they heard it from someone else. It might be just half true. Now, truth is more important. But sometimes gossip is more interesting. And I know the truth can sometimes be painful. But gossip always hurts someone. Just remember that next time you tell a story you're not sure is true.
I think Judd is sick, sick, sick. I mean, my goodness gracious. The man is a nightmare.
Marty is so afraid he's just gonna come take Shiloh or hurt him or something. Mm.
Emily is under orders to stay far away from him.
Oh, we just want him out of our lives, that's all.
No kidding, you have children. That's your first responsibility. The rehabilitation of a public nuisance is not even on your list.
Every day I wonder what is going to happen next, and I tell you, it just scares me.
I'm telling you, we could all boycott him. Nobody buys from him. Nobody sells to him.
That is just so mean-spirited, though, Sue.
Well, look what he's capable of.
I know. Ray's been trying to be a friend to him since they were kids. Look what good it's done. It's the same, isn't he?
The man is who he is. End of story. But if you're smart, you'll keep your son away from him.
Anybody home? Shiloh!
Where are you, boy?
Shiloh! Shiloh!
You're all right.
I got so scared. I didn't know where you were.
Yeah.
put the mail in my box and keep moving, Ray.
I'm the one who should be angry. It's your dogs that attacked my daughter.
I ain't got no use in talking to you. Just keep moving.
Me, Becky.
Want to hear your baby sister?
Honey, don't talk with food in your mouth. Do you have some spinach?
Yuck. It looks like poop.
Becky.
Poop, poop, poop.
I haven't seen you laugh in a long time.
Yeah, sometimes you just have to laugh a little.
How's she doing? Oh, well, that's encouraging. Well, you're a good son to her, honey.
Thank you.
Oh, good. Yeah, things are fine here. Quiet.
And the kids?
The girls are sleeping. Marty's studying. I'm going to go up and do some reading.
Won't be long.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
I love you.
I love you, too. Good night, honey.
What you doing, dog? What you doing? Come here. Come on over here, dog. Come on over here when I call you. Where you going, you stupid idiot? Huh? Where you going? Come on! Come on back here!
That's shiloh barking. I gotta find it.
Well, Marty, I don't want you going out there.
Mom, it's just up the road, okay? I can hear it.
Well, hold on then. Let me get a flashlight.
I don't know. Never saw Shiloh scared of thunder.
Marty, be careful. Come right back.
I know I've said and thought a lot of bad things about Judd Travers. But please, help him get well. Maybe don't let his legs get well enough to ever go hunting again. No, that's not right. Help him get well in his head, too. Wake him up to his mean ways. Really what I'm asking.
Now, we all know that Judd Travers was seriously injured in a truck accident on Saturday night. And seeing as how he's one of our neighbors, I thought, instead of talking about things we're not sure of, why don't we do something nice? I thought we'd make a big card and send it to Judd for the whole class.
Miss Talbot?
Yes, ma'am.
Most of us won't be able to come up with something nice to say to Judd.
Well, the great thing about the English language is there's enough words to say anything at all. If you don't want to say something one way, you can say it another. So what could we say that would be both helpful and honest?
But Miss Talbot, the truth is we're not really sorry about his accident.
Marty, what about just get well?
Okay. What does everyone think about get well?
That's good.
Okay.
Fine with me.
It's good? Okay. That's what we'll do. That's a good idea. Thanks for your input, guys.
Thank you.
Come on, get out of there, boy.
Fine, stay.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Good news, honey.
I don't have rabies.
5 weeks passed before Judd came home from the hospital. While he was gone, I took care of his dogs. I didn't think anybody else would.
Get out of the way.
Doc Wallace. Nobody even looked in on Judd at the hospital. Guess everybody else gave up on him a long time ago.
Doc Wallace.
Going away, Doc. I said going away.
How you feeling?
I'm alive.
That makes two of us, doesn't it? I just want to check your stitches. Did a good job. Mrs. Wallace will be by in the morning. She's going to be your nurse.
Doc, I don't need nobody playing nursemaid to me.
In the morning. Miss Wallace went to see him this morning, and he wouldn't even talk to her. Put that over there.
Well, he must have a lot of bad luck.
Well, yeah. Luck's a funny thing, you know. Sometimes you get a streak of bad luck you can't do anything about, and then sometimes you get a streak of bad luck that's all your own fault. Judd had a little bit of both.
What was the bad luck he couldn't do anything about?
Well, you got to think of the family he was born into.
Did you know?
Well, I got to know him because people used to tell me stories about him, my patients, and they were so much alike. I figured, well, there had to be some truth in it. I said that old man Travis, the father, he was very cruel and he beat the kids. The 5 older ones, they just took off, left Judd alone with his father, and then they said Travis used to beat Judd to get even with the 5 that ran away.
What happened to the parents?
It was about 15, and they died one after another. He's been up there ever since, sitting on his land all by himself. Just him and the dogs.
He didn't have any friends?
Not that I know of. Not even the dogs. I mean, you can't beat dogs and expect them to be your friend.
First he's the kid getting the beating, then he's the grown-up giving it.
You gotta remember one thing. Kindness in life is something you have to learn.
Why didn't you teach him?
Good question. Maybe we should have tried harder.
Dad, can we go visit Judd tomorrow?
No, 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 no. I've been knocking on that man's door every time I deliver the mail, and he doesn't answer.
You figure he'll stop drinking now?
Well, they say that only when a man hits bottom does he stop.
I'm thinking he may look in the mirror and see how bad he's hurt and just be madder than ever. We gotta try to help him.
You know, Marty, some people never change. And Judd is one of them.
You really believe that?
I really do.
Dad, please, can't we just try?
Okay, Marty. But I'm doing it for you, not Judd Travers.
What you want, Rick Preston?
Well, we just came by to say hello.
Well, I don't need no hellos.
All right, but do you need any groceries or anything we can get you?
I don't need nothing.
All right. But, you do know, don't you, that people are concerned about you. Everybody is.
Is that a fact?
That's a fact. Well, Marty, I guess that's the.
See? It's all healed up now. You can hardly see it. I've learned a lot about veterinary medicine from having Shiloh as my dog. It's not just about the medicine part. Animals really need to feel that you love them, and they can tell, too. The same caring helps in the healing, also. So taking care of animals is what I really like to do as a grown-up. Working as a vet is what I see myself doing for my whole life. That's great, Mike. Take your time. Thanks. Yeah, bring it back here, Shiloh. Good boy. Good boy, Shiloh. Bring it to him. Go get it. Mom, you think we could fix up something for Judd every day to go along with his mail? You know, like something to eat?
I think you should leave the man alone, Marty. After all he's done to this family, I don't want a thing to do with him.
Come on, Mom, I'm just trying to show some kindness. I never had anybody try that for him before.
So is this about kindness or about making friends so we won't go after Shiloh?
Both, I guess. Each one by itself, I think, is a really good reason. So, you got anything for him to eat? Thanks. I'll go wrap it up. Dropped off food for Judd 3 days straight. The mail was gone. The food was still there. He wouldn't even let Mrs. Wallace take it in.
Not just the world he's mad at, he's mad at himself.
And he thinks if he takes anything from us, he owes us something.
Mm-hmm. I think he feels so bad about himself, You don't even think he has a right to that food.
Right.
Maybe so, but it's been 3 days now. We don't have that kind of food to waste.
What kind of mail does he get?
Junk mail, bills, like that.
Does he ever get any letters?
No. None that I can remember.
Here, give this to Judd, okay?
I know. But this is it with the food, Marty. You've been too nice.
Okay, thanks.
Medicine refill, mail, and some more food from Marty. Looks like you got a letter.
A letter?
Yeah. Don't you want to read it?
Would you mind reading it?
I'd be happy to. Let's see. Okay. Dear Judd, last month Shiloh was chasing a butterfly. You should have seen him. Was running and looking behind him both at the same time, and he run into a bush. Thought that he'd chase that butterfly right down to the creek. I hope you get well, Marty.
Marty wrote this.
He sure did. Now, Judd, you're going to have to stand up so I can check the stitches on your back.
That was kind of funny, what Marty wrote.
Yeah, it was kind of.
Eating the food, and Mrs. Wallace read him the letters I sent him. I hear from Doc and Mrs. Wallace that he was healing nicely. At least his body was. All that I could think was now that we got Judd all shut up in his house. Maybe slowly, a little bit at a time. Gotta teach him some new ways.
So Shiloh is up to 18 pounds. That's why he's on a diet. Dr. Collins said he's got to get more exercise, too. You would have laughed as hard as me watching Shiloh take off after a mole. Fast as Shiloh could dig, That mole was tunneling away from it.
Well, keep going.
Oh, okay. Then Shiloh and I went to the creek.
Days passed. Then a few more weeks went by. Finally, Judd started to feed his dogs himself. But aside from when Mrs. Wallace came, every other minute he sat in that chair alone.
Chow hounds. What you do is eat. Just eat. God earned your keep around here. Don't stop you from eating, though, does it?
After all the small talk I made in the other notes, I decided to tell Joe what was really on my mind. So I wrote, Dear Judd.
Now, after everything you've done to Shiloh, when you were pinned
under
your truck,
at the bottom of the ravine, in the dark, dead at night, far from any house except ours, Shiloh started barking and whining. Shiloh cried loud enough and long enough to get me out of the house and onto the road. Shiloh could have just sneaked on home. He would have died, probably. I want to tell you that it wasn't me, or even the rescue squad that saved your life. It was Shiloh. That's it.
That's it.
Plain and simple.
Plain and simple.
I wonder why he didn't say anything to Doc about my letters.
Honey, you can't expect Judd to act in a friendly way. It's not his nature.
Can we go visit Judd tomorrow?
What makes you think he's gonna let you in this time?
Nothing. I just want to try is all. I want to stop all this fighting.
I'll talk to your dad about it, okay?
Okay. Wait a second, Dad. I gotta get something first. Going for a little trip, boy.
Marty, are you sure you want to do this?
No. But it's only a visit. It's okay, boy.
Oh, he knows where we're going.
Yep. You're mine, as long as you live. I promise you that.
Visitor here for you. I know he's in there. I can hear him moving around. Judd?
What you want?
Well, I got someone here who wants to see you.
We just came to visit.
For a minute. Sit down if you want. Well, go ahead.
Sit down.
Thanks. So, it's nice to see you up around. How you feeling?
I'm doing okay.
Good, good. That's good.
Well, Chip?
Oh, thanks very much.
He's the one who found me.
Yep.
Yep. He was making all these weird noises. They like him out. Pound your truck.
I suppose he remembers me. Chip.
And that's my story. Now me and my family aren't afraid to walk outside anymore. All because we showed a little bit of kindness to someone who never had that in his life before.
Dumber than you going out there and getting wet. Huh. Some kind of fine mess I'm turning into. What you doing out here, boy? Getting all wet? Yeah, gummy. Go on, get out of the rain. Go on, get out of the rain.
Breathe under like that.
Go on, get in under the porch. Not in there! What are you doing going in there? You gonna get my place all wet? Well, look here.
There have been rumors that Judd gave each of his dogs their own name.
Said you didn't want her off your name.
Somebody even heard that Judd said that Marty Preston was all right by him. But that's only a rumor. Kind of like gossip. You know what I think, though? Knowing Judd the way I know him, I think it's true.
So long, I wait and see.
free.
I just need